Friends, brothers and sisters, number five, even in times of crisis and the deepest despair, there are those who follow God and through whom God works. I repeat again, even in times of crisis, we are in times of crisis. We are in times of difficulties. We are in times of lack. We are in times of confusion. We are in times of battles from every corner. Friends, even in these times of crisis and the deepest despair, there are men and women who have despaired already in life. They don't know what will happen. A man of God has just called me, and he has told me, man of God, where are we headed to? And I've just told him, my friend, the best times are ahead of us. We're going to enjoy life. We're going to serve God like never before. We're going to pray. We're going to organize rallies. We're going to go deeper in the things of God. Brothers and sisters, in Jesus' mighty name, there are men and women right now who have remained strong. No matter what happens, no matter what comes on our way, we have hope. We are standing by the hope we have from the Word of God. Men and women of God, point number six, under Naomi. No matter how hard and discouraging the world may seem, there are always people who follow God faithfully. No matter what happens, no matter the roadblocks, no matter the wars, no matter the battles, no matter the sicknesses and diseases, there are men and women whom we call remnants, who are purposed in their hearts and they have made up their minds that no matter what happens, they can lack money, they can lack the pleasures that men are looking forward for, they can lack all these things that men are looking forward to receive, but they say no matter what happens, we will follow our God. Brothers and sisters, let not our positions blind us from not following God. Let not our good jobs blind us not to honor God and respect God. This is a time that we need to go on our knees, humble ourselves, and ask God for forgiveness if we have worshipped wealth more than God, if we have worshipped our positions more than God. Friends, brothers and sisters, point number seven, God will use anyone who is open to him to achieve his purposes. I repeat again clearly that point number seven under Naomi, God will use anyone who is open to him to achieve his purposes here on earth. God is going to use you who has been despised. God is going to use you who is down there if you love God, if you are faithful to God, if you are committed to the things of God. God will not forget you. God will pick you right from where you are and he will bless you before great and mighty people so that he can prove himself powerful to humanity. Friends, point number eight, Ruth was a Moabite and Boaz was a descendant of Rahab, a former prostitute from Jericho. I repeat again, Ruth was a Moabite. She was not from Naomi's place. She was a Moabite. Now, Boaz was a descendant of Rahab, a former prostitute from Jericho, a lady who had no name. She had no future. She was a prostitute, a very bad business, according to our societies. Brothers and sisters, but God is not a respecter of persons. The moment you repent from your heart, the moment you humble, the moment you tune your life to the kingdom of heaven, God will always forgive you and use you the way you are. I pray for God's forgiveness. upon the sins we have committed against him. I pray for God's forgiveness against the dishonor that we have showed him. Brothers and sisters, we serve a forgiving God. We serve a God of mercy. We serve a God of love. Friends, brothers and sisters, point number 9 quickly. Nevertheless, their offspring continued the family line, through which the Messiah came into our world. The Messiah followed that line, the line of despise, the line of difficulties, the line of challenges. All these characters had to go through challenges that were not very easy. But God who is above, God who sees, God who restores, God who loves, came upon these characters, and through them, the Messiah came. Friends, something powerful will come out of you. Something supernatural is prepared in your life. Friends, point number 10 quickly. God is at work in the world, and he wants to use you. God is at work, and nobody can stop him. The challenges we are going through cannot stop God from fulfilling his purposes upon humanity. Maybe you are seated there and you are saying, man of God, I'm useless. Man of God, I've been looking for a job for many years, but I've not succeeded. I have given up in life. Never give up in life, because God will use the rejects. God will use those who seem not be doing very well to assume the world that he is God. Friends, brothers and sisters, your miracle is here today, and your miracle is tied to the word of God. Never tie your life to the worldly things. Never tie your life to the things that fail. Never tie your life to things which are here temporarily. Everything we see was created by God. Everything you touch, everything that moves, everything that gives you comfort, everything that gives you life, were created by God. My desire and my prayer for us is to return back to God. Let us go. There is power to cause us to return back to God. There is the power of forgiveness. Jesus Christ was sent to come from above so that he can come and die on the cross, so that whoever believes in him will not perish but will have eternal life. My prayer for us, children of the Most High God, is that in our comfort zones, in our homes, in our places of work, wherever you are and you are listening to me, my prayer for us is that there is power to cause us to return back. God is calling every human being. He is calling me. He is calling you. He is calling us to go back to him. Brothers and sisters, where the world is heading to, it's not a safe place for humanity. Friends, brothers and sisters, even the governments of this world are confused. If you ask our leaders what is next, they don't understand. They don't know, because nobody knows, nobody understands what is happening today. Friends, brothers and sisters, men and women of God, I want us to pray together, because I believe that God is a miracle working God. And we can be able to receive a miracle of return, because there is power to cause us to return. The dying of Jesus Christ, the power on the cross, is the power to cause us to return. Why are we supposed to return? We are supposed to return so that we can be reconciled back to God. We are supposed to return back so that God can secure us and our families. We are supposed to return to God in repentance so that God can forgive us and save our nation. The Bible says, if my people who are called by my name, 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse number 14, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves, turn away from their wicked ways, and pray, I will hear, and I will heal their land. Brothers and sisters, if we return to God, God will heal nations. God will heal counties. God will heal villages in the name of Jesus. As we stand right now, In the name of Jesus, God is asking all of us, men and women, young and old, rich and poor, rejected and those who are accepted, to return back to Him. There is a chance for all of us to return back to God. My prayer for all of us is the child of God, children of the Most High God, can we return to God? Can God hear our prayers today? Can God forgive us? Yes, God is able to forgive us. God is able to pardon all our sins in Jesus' mighty name. I'm gonna read Psalms 136, verse number 4, quickly. The Bible says, only God works great miracles. God's love never fails. God's love never fails. He loves you the way you are. He accepts you the way you are. Maybe you are there and you feel rejected. Maybe you are there and you feel you cannot amount to anything in life. You are the person God is looking for. He says, come the way you are, and God will be able to forgive you. Psalm 72, verse number 18. Lord God of Israel, we praise you. Only you can work miracles. Only God can work miracles. A miracle to return can only be worked out by God. A miracle to heal can only be done by the Almighty God. A miracle to restore our families and return back to where we were can only be done by God. Brothers and sisters, this miracle-working God is waiting for you. This miracle-working God is waiting for me. Friends, brothers and sisters, lastly, Exodus 15, 11. Oh Lord, no other gods, oh my God, compare with you, majestic and holy, fearsome and glorious miracle worker. You are a miracle worker. You are our comfort. You are our tomorrow. We cannot see tomorrow without you. We cannot see the future without your hand. Brothers and sisters, right where you are, in the name of Jesus, I'm going to pray for you. And I'm going to declare that the Lord of all power will touch you right where you are. He will minister to your situation. He will minister to your problem. He will minister to that desire that you have. God cannot fail. A man can fail. Medicine can fail. Science can fail. But when we return to God, God will always return to us. Brothers and sisters, men and women of God, I don't know who you are. I don't know where you are. But I know that I've spoken the word of God, that there is power to return. There is power to return. Can you purpose to return to God? Maybe you are there, you were a strong believer. The other day I was washing a car, and a man came to me, a young man, a very young man. He walked to me and told me, Pastor Jasper, I know you. I said, yes, how can I help you? He said, oh, Pastor Jasper, many years ago I was coming to the church, and I was worshiping together with you. But many years now, I've been out. And I told him, young man, God wants you to return. God wants to forgive you. You are precious. You are special before God. And they told me, man of God, do you think God can forgive me? I told him, yes, God is able to forgive you. No matter what you've done, people can condemn you. People can run away from you. People can call you names. But brothers and sisters, if God forgave Rahab and Jesus came through the line of Rahab, who are you not be forgiven? And then I prayed for him. He returned back to the kingdom. Brothers and sisters, men and women of God, the grace of God is available for us. The grace of God is here to make sure that you return back to God, and God will return back to you. In Jesus' mighty name, I'm going to pray for you right now. You've listened to the word of God shortly, and you are there, you are saying, man of God, I am a sinner, or I was born again but I backslid, and I want to come back to God. I'm going to pray for you quickly. If you are there, you've never given your life to Jesus, Or you are there, you had given your life to Jesus, but you backslid and you went back to the enemy. God loves you. And God has a second chance for you. Please, I want you to pray this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you and I pray that you forgive me every sin I've committed. Father, I know that you are a loving God. You loved me before I was born. Now, oh God, accept me in your kingdom as your own child. I pray all this believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen. If you have prayed that prayer, please make sure that you go to a church that preaches the word of God in truth, and you will be helped. And if you can be able to come to us, we welcome you. We come to you from Deliverance Church, Kisumu City. Right here, we have one church, two locations. One is at Kondele, first service from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. Also, the mega church, we begin the services from 9 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. Most welcome, and I thank God for you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.